Hello, in this short video I'm going to be introducing you to the subject of subdomains, and we're going to install WordPress on that subdomain, and then I'm going to show you how to link from your main site to your subdomain in your menu settings. The reason why we're creating a subdomain is so that we can have an independent space where our multimedia digital story can live, that will have a unique layout that is distinct from perhaps your main website. This website will not necessarily work for what we need to be able to do for our multimedia story, which is essentially have one page with narrative and some multimedia and video and audio on it. Okay. Very quickly, what is a subdomain? So a website owner creates a subdomain when they want to portion off a part of their site, their website, or domain, which is another word for website, because the new portion will have unique characteristics, such as a wholly new subject or design, but the website content owner doesn't want to pay for a new URL. Subdomains don't have an additional cost. It's just another portion of the website that they already have. You can name a subdomain anything, but the website owner can name it anything, but it helps if the name is meaningful and relates to the content, okay? And a subdomain, a subdomain can have software such as WordPress installed on it that will act independently from the software installed on the main domain. So for example, here we're going to be using a theme called Himalaya, which gives us this nice one-page layout. But that installing that WordPress theme on your subdomain won't have any effect on the domain, on the theme that you're using for your main domain or your main URL. So when we're thinking about the structure of the URL for a subdomain, it's very very minor change from the main domain. So here, this is my main domain, http://billwolfsjo.com. A subdomain will have a little phrase before, followed by a period, before the main domain. So here we're going to create one called story. billwolfsju.com, and we're calling it stories because it's going to be a multimedia story. You could write out multimedia story, but for the sake of concision, we'll just use the word story for this, and that way it's all consistent across and I can help you with any problems that you might be having by finding it very quickly. All right, so in order to create this, it's not very difficult. You're going to need to have Reclaim Hosting logged in. And you're going to go into your cPanel, and you're going to click on subdomains right here. They have it set up for you very easily. Come on, you could do it. Thinking. Okay. And I'm just going to type in under subdomain, I'm going to type in story. And click create. I'll go back. And you can see I have lots of different ones. And my com WordPress site is actually a subdomain. But here it is, story.billwolfsjo.com. That's great, right there. And I'm going to go back to home. And now that that's created, I can install WordPress on it. I'm going to click WordPress. And install this application. And now here I need to choose the domain that I'm going to install it on. And I want it to be installed on story.billwolf.com. And yours would be story.whatever your URL is.com. Or .edu or whatever you've created. So I'm going to find story.billwolf.sju.com, and I'm going to delete blog, and this is very important. We need to delete the word blog here and delete that, and that's because I don't want WordPress installed in a blog directory. I want it just to be right there on the main one. Accept the license, update to any new version, update WordPress plugins, do not update the theme. That's very important. Do not update the theme because we don't want that to take place. Create a backup and automatically restore backup if update fails. That's good. I'm going to create a username. And make sure you write that down. My email. And for the title, this could be just temporary right now. I'm going to call it My Multimedia Story. You are going to come up with a title for your individual stories. And you're going to have a meaningful tagline, but this should be just be temporary for this moment. Okay. Keep that. That's good. And then you're going to click install. And it's processing. It takes a few seconds as we remember. Scroll down. Here it is. Okay, great. Now I can click on story.billwolf.com and it will take me to, here it is. WordPress has been installed on it. Very nice. It is distinct from my current website. You can see the URL, story.billwolfsju.com. When I want to go to the, to log in, excuse me, when I want to go to the admin, I would click on story.billwolfsju.com/wp-admin, and then I would be able to log in and change the theme and do everything else that I need to do, create the content and so on. Okay, so now what we'd like to be able to do is link from my main page in the main navigation bar to this page. So when people come to my site, if they're curious, they can actually read the multimedia story that you're creating. So here I'm going to click on Customize, and I'm going to click Menus, and then Primary Menu. And I'm going to click Add Items. And I'm going to click a custom link. And I'm going to come here. I'll copy the URL from my subdomain. Paste it in. And I'm going to type in multimedia story. You could just say story if you want, something shorter. And I'm going to click Add to Menu. And you can see it has appeared right here. I'm going to slide this up next to photography. And I'm going to click publish. Now I'll close this down. And I can click on multimedia story and it will take me now to the story. Okay. And if you have any questions for me, please let me know.